Hey, New Hope, so glad that you've joined us for today's daily devotional. It's an exciting week, and we've got an exciting weekend coming up as we celebrate our 30-year anniversary. I'm sitting in the lobby upstairs of the second level of the main campus, and I look out the window and I see all the excitement going on out here. All the houses have come down, and they're doing dirt work to put together the parking lot that's just going to be to the north. Exciting times as we see progress taking place. That parking lot will be ready this fall, and just exciting to see us moving forward as a church. This weekend we have our missions banquet Friday night. Pastor John Lindell from James River Church in Springfield is going to be with us for our missions banquet, and we have Doug Clay, our general superintendent of the Assemblies of God, with us this Sunday morning speaking in our morning services. We've got four Sunday morning services. Encourage you to make an in-person service if you can. 8 o'clock, 9:30, and 11. We've got a second 9:30 service happening at the same time the service in the sanctuary is taking place. There is another service happening at 9:30 in the student campus auditorium. It's our mask on service, and we've got a number of people joining there. There's plenty of room in all of our services for you to come and join us. But if you can't make an in-person service, please join us online this Sunday as we celebrate our 30-year anniversary. In the afternoon, we're gonna have a celebration time. We've got some food trucks coming in from 4 to 6. It was gonna be at Lions Park, but we've moved that to the student campus. And so we're gonna be have some inside options for you to sit. It's gonna be more of a cool day on Sunday. And so be at the student campus from 4 to 6. Bring some lawn chairs. You can sit outside. We've got places inside. Just a time for us to gather together to celebrate the goodness of God and what He's done. We've been in a sermon series in the book of Joshua through the month of September, and that's going to continue in the Sunday evening messages in the month of October. The book of Joshua is an amazing book, and some exciting things take place. One of the things that that stands out the most to me in the book of Joshua is them crossing the Jordan River into the Promised Land. And the Bible tells us that all of Israel crossed the Jordan River. While it was at flood stage, God pushed back the waters and they crossed over the Jordan River on dry ground. Amazing story. And I want to pick up in Joshua chapter 4, where the Lord says this to Joshua. After the whole nation finished crossing the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, "Choose 12 men from among the people, one from each tribe, and tell them to take up 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan, from right where the priests are standing, and carry them over with you, and put them down at the place where you stay tonight." Verse 6, it tells us that these stones are to serve as a sign among you. In the future, when your children ask you, "What do these stones mean?" tell them that the flow of the Jordan River was cut off before the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. When it crossed the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off, and these stones are to be a memorial to the people of Israel forever. We need to remember what God has done in our life. That's why memorials are important, because we forget so easily. They say that we forget more than 90% of the information that we take in. Yet every one of us has enough information stored in our brains to fill the Library of Congress. That's a lot. God says that these stones are to be a memorial to the people of Israel forever. So first, memorial stones were to be a reminder of their own personal experience. We notice that in verse 6, this memorial will cause the children to ask, "What do these stones mean to you?" These stones are first of all to be a reminder to those who are present of their personal experience, what they saw, what they heard, what they felt. Tell your story. Keep in your own memory what God did for you. And keep on telling your stories so that you never lose your own sense of awe and wonder at what God has done in your life. I want you to consider with me, what kind of memorials do you have in your life? Whether you realize it or not, we all have memorial stones or markers in our life. These monuments aren't built of stones, but built of memories and experiences. There's memories of places that trigger memories, just as the memorial stones in Gilgal did. There are some significant places in your life that elicit memories, the place where you were saved. Burned in my memory is the place where I was baptized in the Holy Spirit, where I was called into ministry, the place where I was married. And when I have a chance to go back to those places, I'm flooded with memories of what God did in my life in those places. There are special places that remind us of things that God has done in our lives. No doubt you have such places in your memories. There are memories not only of places, but of people. Those people whom God has used in your life to bring you where you are today. But how often do we think about the memories? And how often do we thank God for those people who have impacted our lives for God's purposes and God's glory in us? There are memories of experiences where God answered prayer or made a miraculous provision. See, the lessons that we learn through these experiences of faith are not something that can be taught. It's something that you must experience to truly understand them. There's mementos of the past. We all have some of these miscellaneous objects that are reminders of experiences. Maybe a missions trip that you went on and you've got a picture or a plaque or some kind of a memento that reminds you of what God has done in your life. Those objects trigger memories of what happened, what God did, experiences that have changed their lives. I have a lawnmower at my house, and I've told this story many times. Some of you could repeat the story yourself. A lawnmower that has run on multiple occasions without gas. And I'm telling you, in those moments, God got my attention. That mower no longer runs. I've got a new mower, but that mower still sits in my shed, and that mower will be with me forever because it's a memorial of what God did in my own life and how he spoke to me and really changed me and built faith in me to believe God for anything. So I challenge you to spend some time thinking through your memorial stones. Let them draw you closer to God and remind you of his faithfulness in your past and build your faith for the future. Secondly, memorial stones are to serve as a basis for sharing their faith with their children. Verses 6 and 7 tell us that. Two places in this chapter where parents are reminded of their responsibility of communicating God's word and his calling on their children, generation after generation. Verses 20 to 23, as we read there, it says, Joshua set up at Gilgal the 12 stones that they had taken out of the Jordan. And he said to the Israelites, in the future, when your descendants ask their parents, what do these stones mean? Tell them, Israel crossed the Jordan on dry ground. For the Lord your God dried up the Jordan before you until you had crossed over. The Lord your God did to the Jordan what he had done to the Red Sea when he dried it up before us until we had crossed over. He did this so all the peoples of the earth might know that the hand of the Lord is powerful, and so that you might always fear the Lord your God. The intention of the memorial in the Old Testament was to provoke questioning, especially from future generations. Christianity is never more than one generation away from extinction. We need our children to ask those questions. I'm always amazed when my children will tell stories that they have heard us tell, and they're repeating stories, and they weren't even alive necessarily when that event took place. It's important that we remember. So Deuteronomy 6 says that these commandments are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home, when you walk along the road, when you lie down, when you get up. So it's bedtime, it's drive time, it's dinner time, it's any time you have an opportunity. We're to talk to our kids about these things. Verse 12 goes on to say, be careful that you do not forget the Lord who brought you up out of Egypt. So thirdly, the memorial stones were to be a signpost to the lost, to a lost world. He did this so that all the peoples of the earth might know that the hand of the Lord is powerful, and so that you might always fear the Lord your God. It's always been God's plan that the whole world should know that he is the only living God. Not only was the crossing of the Jordan a magnificent event for Israel, but it was also an event that made all the people living in the land of Canaan sit up and take notice. So this Sunday, we're celebrating our 30-year anniversary as a church. And it's what an exciting time as we take a moment to look back to see all the amazing things that God has done, that God has brought us through. We have many memorial stones as reminders of God's incredible power and love for his people. But that serves only to build our faith in our faithful God as we look to the future and forge ahead, building God's kingdom and serving his purpose and fulfilling his plans right here in Urbandale, in the Des Moines metro area, and around the world. I hope that you'll take time today to remember, to think about those memorial stones in your own life. And let's as a church remember what God has done, never forgetting the amazing things that God has done, that he can do, that he will do. And let's forge ahead with faith in our future. We're celebrating 30 years of our past, and we're excited for the next 30 years to see what God is going to do. I hope you'll join with us. Let's be in prayer. Let's be expecting, and let's stand back and be amazed at what God is going to do. God bless you. You're an amazing church. We love you.